Hey friends, another day, another haul. It's Friday. Thank goodness. I have like three packages here. That I'm very excited to unbox. I'm feeling grateful today. I'm feeling good today. I just came back from the chiropractor. Shout out to LifeSpring Chiropractic for always getting me in a great place. And shout out to Vibe with Aid for the recommendation. I've been going there for the past 2 months and it has been just such a good experience. I'm gonna start with the box that makes the most sense, which is Sephora. I wanted to get more skincare, but honestly, my skin has been so weird and I think it might be just because I'm acclimating still to living in the South and the weather and all that stuff. It's literally 80 degrees today. And it's November like 13th. So there's that. I went from being in a cool climate, having actual falls, to this. So I think I'm just kind of bugging a bit. My skin is kind of freaking out. These are the three products that I got in the Sephora sale. One of them you all are probably gonna drag me for, but I'm gonna explain it. And then the other two are just like things I've wanted. So I'll just start with the one that y'all are gonna drag me for, because I know y'all are gonna drag me. So I got Tan Luxe, the self-tanning face drops, which honestly, if I'm thinking about it, probably isn't the best idea for me because of what my skin is going through. But basically, Tan Luxe's brand came up with like illuminating tanning drops that you can put on your face. They're like specially made for your face. Like, I'm black, right? So it's like, why do I need a tan? But honestly, if you guys can't tell, which you probably can't because you haven't been, like, I haven't been filming for that long, but I'm very, very pale right now, considering. So, and as it goes into winter, obviously it's gonna get colder, and I never really got a good tan this year, obviously, because it was COVID and I just like didn't go outside ever. I feel like my face especially always looks so pale, and I think it makes my face look really bad. Like, I really like the way I look when I have a tan. And so the fact that I haven't had a tan all year, I just feel like my self-esteem is not that great. So I figure I got the medium dark, obviously, because I'm actually black, so I'm gonna need to see what it's giving. But I got this. It says mix 1 to 4 drops to your usual moisturizer, serum, or face oil and apply to the face. Additional drops will increase depth of color. Wash hands thoroughly after application. We'll see. It has raspberry seed oil, aloe leaf in it, some vitamin E. So we'll see. We will see. On to the next thing. So then I also got the Laneige lip sleeping mask. Amazing. It's technically, like I said, a lip sleeping mask, but I use it as a lip balm because it's super hydrating. It used to, oh, it does still, yay. It comes with this cute little applicator and I use it a lot. I'm not almost out of my last one, but it's definitely like super, super low to the bottom. So I figured I would just buy this in anticipation. I also bought the lip glowy balm from Laneige. And this is a new flavor, I think. It's peach. Like, is it giving peach? Or no? It doesn't smell that peachy though, but it kind of like tastes, I can feel it taste peachy. I don't know, whatever. This is something I've been wanting to get for a minute, and I think I said this in one of my other vlogs, I think. But I think I mentioned it being like, I'm not buying this yet because it's mad expensive and don't nobody got time. But I finally bought it. Boom and boom, baby. Are you ready? And all of my friends that are watching this are gonna know that I'm putting y'all on. Y'all might not know I'm putting y'all on, but trust and believe, baby. So, oh my gosh, yay. And it came with the thing. Okay. Soap Cherie, bros. Soap Cherie is this dope soap company, like bath and body. It gives Lush type vibes. And they are based in Brooklyn. When I lived in Brooklyn, I found out about them because they literally have a store like 15 minutes from my old apartment in Brooklyn. And I went in there one day and I tried this body scrub. And this is the flavor, the smell I wanted. They have a bunch of different scents and stuff that you can get stuff in. And I got the lavender patchouli. So this is the lavender patchouli body scrub, and then this is the orchid body lotion. They didn't have the lavender patchouli body lotion, but it's fine because I feel like it's kind of nice to mix the orchid and the lavender patchouli, because sometimes if you layer it too much, I feel like it can be a lot. But this is by far the best body scrub I've ever used, like 10 out of 10. It's granular enough where it actually does exfoliating, but then it leaves your body soft. Like after you get out of the shower, you don't even really need to put this on, but this body lotion is so thick and so moisturizing. Both of these products have vitamin E in them as well, which is super moisturizing and good for you. This is so moisturizing. You don't even need that much. You only need a little after you use the body scrub, and then you like are in heaven. So this was a self-care buy. These are honestly, like, I'm leveling with y'all. These are expensive as hell for no reason. I mean, not for no reason. They're like incredible body products, but if you invest in them, you'll have them for a really, really, really long time. It takes me a long time to get through the scrub, and it takes me an even longer time to get through the lotion. With the scrub, they also give you this cute little like spatula to scoop it out with. This is big, big self-care day. Big self-care day things.
Good morning. How are y'all doing? It is 11 a.m.
I'm gonna brush my teeth, wash my face, then I'm gonna put on stuff to work out, because I know if I don't do it now, I'm not gonna do it.
Real-ish. I was carrying myself for buying these Tan Luxe face drops. Look, I was being a hater because I put this on yesterday. I put like a dropper, not like a whole dropper, but I put like maybe like 3 drops on. It says 1 to 4 drops in your moisturizer. So I put 3 drops on and then I put my moisturizer on. Bro, my face is tan. Like, you guys probably can't tell, but my face is tan, so it's lit. We're out here.
I'm gonna wash my...
I just put on a workout set because I've decided I'm not gonna do Seoul right now. I'm gonna do it later, but I'm going to clean my apartment right now. That is really that. I am continuing the vlog. I just wanted to get on here and level set though, because I don't feel that great today. And I feel like there's a lot on my mind that I want to just get out. So this is just gonna be kind of a chit chat vibe. I won't ramble too long, but I've just been in a weird space in terms of trying to navigate like what friendship looks like right now, what my mental health looks like right now. I know like everyone's going through it, like it's a pandemic, so it's mad difficult to do pretty much anything, but it's just been a lot of me, I think, facing some of my old traumas too, from like middle and high school, of, you know, being the girl that's left out or being the girl that's not chosen or not being blank enough, not being funny enough, pretty enough, skinny enough, rich enough, cool enough, you know? So it's hard. It's a hard thing. And I'm really trying to do some self-growth in way of understanding that that trauma has nothing to do with my present. And also any changes I want to make to myself, I can make. And it shouldn't be based in other people. It shouldn't be based in me wanting to look a certain way or be a certain way. And I shouldn't feel pressured by the people that I'm surrounding myself with to like ascribe to certain like personality traits or hobbies or anything, like anything, you know? Like I shouldn't feel, I don't know. I'm saying all this, you guys are probably like, where is this coming from? I'm saying all of this just because I have been feeling a lot of like feelings come up that I thought were kind of dead, like that I thought I would never really feel again because I'm 25 and I'm living alone and all the decisions I've made, you know? But I think it can be easy, especially for me, to really internalize parts of myself and feel like that's why people don't wanna interact with me or be friends with me, and or that's why people leave my life. That's why, you know, I don't have anyone to talk to, or and as I say that, I'm like getting emotional because this is the narrative that I tell myself. It's just important to tell yourself that you are enough as you are, and you don't need anyone in your life that makes you feel like you need to be someone else, that makes you feel like you aren't enough, that makes you feel like you need to change or be this type of person or exclude people or be weird. Like, you don't need any of that in your life. The right people are the right people, and they will stick around and they will be loyal and they will love you as you are. And the wrong people are the wrong people. And it doesn't matter how much anything they have, money, clout, beauty, fame, whatever, none of that matters. Because honestly, at the end of the day, when you're acting like someone you're not to be with people, to be liked by people, that, like, that's soul draining, and you will feel that. It just soul drains you. And or you get to a point where you don't even remember who you are anymore, and none of it matters. Like, at the end of the day, be yourself and be confident in being yourself, and other people will gravitate toward that more so than you trying to be someone else for them. That's something that I need to remember. And I also need to remember, lately I feel like I've been feeling like really hopeless and down about just doing anything, you know? I have a turntable now, like I have a DDJ, and I've been discouraged by that because I feel like I'm not good enough, or I've been discouraged to not stream on Twitch because I'm not a good enough gamer, I'm not a good enough streamer, I'm not interesting enough. I've been not wanting to do YouTube because I feel like I'm not unique, or I don't have anything cool to say, or no one's gonna like it. Honestly, screw it. Like, it doesn't matter. Do shit because you want to do it and you love it and that's who you are. Like, don't feel like just because other people are doing it or anyone has told you anything that it's true, because you can do whatever you want to do and you are a unique person and your opinion does matter and people will want to watch or will want to listen or whatever. And not everything has to be for people's consumption. Some of it can be just because you love doing it. Like, I like filming, you know, I love editing more so, I think, than I like filming. I don't really enjoy being in front of the camera, if I'm being quite honest, because I'm super critical of myself in many ways, but the process of editing gets me really excited and makes me really happy. And same with mixing. I just started mixing, but I love it. Like, I love music, and there's no better feeling than being able to just play the songs I want to play back to back to back and learn what EQs are and learn how to mix them and crossfade and like do all that. Like, I love that. And it doesn't matter how good I am at it. It doesn't matter if I mess up. It doesn't matter how long it takes me to learn it. It doesn't matter if it's not making me money. I love that, and that should be enough. I can just do things. Like, I can just film and mix and play Switch and play Overwatch, and it doesn't have to be for anyone but myself. Like, and even if I put it out there as media, it doesn't have to be fulfilling anything for anyone else. And I think that is what's gonna free me. I think it's also super freeing for other people to just know that you can do whatever you want, and it literally doesn't matter if you have no audience, if you're not getting paid for it, if people say you're shitty at it, keep doing it. Because if you love it, you love it. That's all that matters. This culture of like having to consume good everything and everyone has to be great at everything, and you can't do something if it's not good, you can't put it out if it's not good, like, screw that. Perfection is an illusion that will destroy you. I just feel like I'm processing and learning a lot right now, and I just wanted to sit down and literally be honest, because I literally spent like an hour just now sitting on my couch feeling like a depressive episode come over me, and feel starting to hear the negative thought loops in my head from my anxiety, and starting to feel like it fill my body with that like uneasy feeling. I'm just trying to stop it. That was a short interlude for the vlog. I'm going to sign off now, because I am going to take some trash out of my apartment, make myself get up, get moving. I'm going to go and get a salad from Sweetgreen, and then I will see you guys when I get back. I definitely looked orange, but it's okay. I got my salad, I'm super hyped. And I also went to Juiceland for the first time, and I got this apple lily juice. Has apples, cucumbers, celery, kale, parsley, and spinach. I'm trying to really, you know, be about Miss Health. I feel a lot better going for a drive and just being out in the sun, like, all that I feel like definitely helped. I'm trying to have today be my chill day, because tomorrow I have work to do. As usual, every Sunday. I'm going to just chill today, but it's hard to chill because I don't even know what chilling entails. Update, I look less orange now. You love to see it, but I look a lot more normal tan versus orange, so we love to see it. I didn't show you guys that I just did Soul Cycle, took a shower, did all of that, used my new soap Cherie. My skin is soft, I'm feeling good. Big self-care moments. I have this Juiceland apple lily drink that I'm drinking right now. I like it. It definitely does taste like celery and cucumbers, but I know it's good for me, so I'm drinking that. I cleaned this kitchen. Actually, I cleaned all of my kitchen counters today. I'm currently about to make these. I got them from Trader Joe's. They are chicken spring rolls, white meat chicken. That's my dryer, sorry. I'm kind of hungry, but I obviously don't want to order because I'll just order bad food, and I don't really have a lot of food here I want to make. I'm not that hungry. I cleaned my counter today. And then I also cleaned this small counter over here. I completely like wiped everything off, like used my anti-bac spray,
clean the toaster, like all of that jam. And then I also cleaned this side. I'm feeling good. It was a pretty productive Saturday, even though I was going light on myself. I think it made me feel good to clean my house and like do laundry, clean myself, get a workout in, all that good stuff. So I'm probably going to get these spring rolls in the oven, choke down the rest of this drink, drink some more water, gonna chill and hang out. I feel a lot better. A lot better than I did earlier today when I kind of went on that rant. So hopefully I'll keep feeling better. Hopefully tomorrow will be a good day. The weekend seemed to be flying by literally one after the next. So I have work to do tomorrow. Sundays are unfortunately not my rest day. They are actually my work day. So I only get one day of the weekend, Saturdays, to chill. I typically only give myself Saturdays to chill, and then I do work on Sundays, which sucks because that basically means I have a one day weekend every week, but it's fine, you know? I got on my Rick and Morty trippy t-shirt. I sleep in this literally all the time. This is like my favorite thing to like be in my house wearing. So happy Sunday. I woke up this morning and, to be honest, didn't feel that great. I don't know. I was kind of just talking about this on Twitter. I don't know if this is the reason, but every month around the same time in my cycle, like my menstrual cycle, I just get very like suicidal. If I'm being honest, like very suicidal. And like, I don't know. When you have any level of like mental illness, like I deal with anxiety and depression, but I can tell that the way that this feels is different than that. Like, I don't think my anxiety or depression is like this bad where like every month I should be this suicidal randomly. Like, it's not even like anything will happen. It's literally like I'll just wake up one day and just feel like so shitty. So I'm starting to think it might be my birth control, which is annoying because it's just annoying. So I'm gonna start looking into alternatives and seeing what would make the most sense for me in terms of switching it over. I really just don't want to continue to be suicidal every month like this and feel crappy and not want to live. So I'm gonna figure that out. I just like can't bring myself to go anywhere during this pandemic. Like every time I'm like, yes, like let's go eat food like alone. Like I wouldn't be going with anyone. I have no friends here and I would literally be going alone, but I just can't justify it. I really can't, because I could get that food delivered or get it taken out and just eat it at home and not be around other people and risk getting corona. So I don't know, it kind of sucks, but I have a panel that I'm gonna be on tonight, so that's cool, but I have to get ready for that. I have a couple meetings for work. It sucks because I know that Sundays are my work days, and I just woke up today and I just feel so blah. I'm mad anxious about the week, but I'm also like demotivated. I like don't want to do anything right now. I don't know. I'll come back and talk to you guys. Hopefully I'll like find some motivation. I just ordered brunch to be picked up in like 25 to 30 minutes. And it's gonna take me like 15-ish minutes to get to the place. So I figured this was the next best step, you know? I get out, I'm able to, ooh, it's kind of chilly out.
Oh no.
It's kind of chilly today, so I guess I can wear pants. Yesterday was so hot and I wore pants anyway, but I think this is a good compromise. I'm gonna get out, drive, get my brunch, come back, and then I can sit and watch maybe a movie or something, eat my brunch, and then I have to get ready at like 4:45 for this panel. And then right after the panel, I have a meeting. I just opened my work emails and was sending out some stuff, getting ready for tomorrow. I find if I open my work emails on Sundays and I go through them and reply and just get an idea of like what's to come, I have a little less anxiety than if I just like wake up on Monday, because I feel like if I wake up without having looked at my emails, it's like, oh, what was going, like what happened? Like, where am I? So I have another virtual event at the end of this week. I will get through it just like I get through everything else. I'm gonna throw on some clothes really quick and then head out to get this food. We out here, I'm in the car. I'm about to head to Snooze. The place that I'm getting brunch from is called Snooze and AM Eatery. And fun fact, I actually, last year when I was still traveling for work and still doing all of that good stuff, when I came to Austin for South By, I went to Snooze like alone. Like I just literally like one day did a, I think I Googled like what the top Austin brunch places were and it was on the list. So I went alone and like had a drink and brunch and stuff and it was mad cool. So full circle moment here. Going back to Snooze, but now as an Austin resident. It's not as cold as I thought. I think it's because I'm on the top floor of my apartment building, so I get like all of the breeze and stuff. It's giving hot, but also fall. So yeah. Then I realize she's right there. I just picked up my food. So now I'm on my way home. There were mad people there like waiting to dine, which was wild. But yeah, I'm on my way back now. I like wrote a tweet basically about like how I think my birth control is messing me up. And everyone is like, bro, that's a thing. Like, don't be appalled by the fact that you're suicidal, because it actually might be your birth control. So now I'm like, I need to figure this ish out, you know what I'm saying?